Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue our Eden Street here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Man, already at 135. I wanna see that, like, quintuple before I start feeling good about this streak. See, day it's gonna be goes paid. We've got Krampus's head, great tears rate, good movement speed to start with, terrible damage, and the stopwatch. Okay. It's not what I would exactly say is a bad start. Krampus's head, of course, is very useful early on for carrying low damage runs against bosses anyway. In a bind, you could use Krampus's head. Ooh, that's good. In a bind, you could use Krampus's head for some room clearing if you think that you're going to have enough. Like this room here, we probably didn't need to do that, but I wanted to sort of err on the side of caution. Another benefit that you would normally get for clearing an XL room is that you get multiple charges now. That was with one of the more recent patches. It wasn't Booster Pack 5, I think it was Booster Pack 4 when they changed that. Maybe even, like, sooner. It might have even been longer than that. So I don't really mind using it on larger rooms, even though we did not get a full... For some reason, we didn't get a multiple charge on that one, even though it was a 2x1. So the stopwatch you see right there, anytime we take any bit of damage whatsoever, it's going to do a spider bite-like slowing effect from the stopwatch. And it's very good. It's very good against crowd control. It's good for really anything. It completely counters Hush, which is another reason why you should love the stopwatch. And the stopwatch is one of those, it's one of those items that's gained a little notoriety for making runs sort of almost boring. And I have also contributed to that notoriety-isms. That's not a word. I'm just gonna say it is. In Rebirth, especially, I was known to do what a lot of other Isaac streamers and YouTubers used to do, which is just simply skip the stopwatch because it just made stuff too easy. Which is true. It did make things easy. But that was the old version. So the stopwatch, the older version of stopwatch, used to actually not require you to take damage. It was on as soon as you took it. That was changed, I think, in Afterbirth. Not Afterbirth Plus, but I think they changed it to Afterbirth, where they had changed that to where now it only activates when you take damage, which is a much better version of the item, because that means that you don't get the instant benefits, like, for just having it. Because it was one of those items that kind of made it too easy. I will contest to that. I think this is definitely worth using a bomb for. Why? Well, because we get our bomb back, plus we might find, like, the petrified poop. Or maybe a little bit of extra money, I don't know, something nice. Or we can find, like, nothing too, that's fine as well. Alright, are we gonna go in the cursed room? Yeah, we're gonna go in the cursed room. Of course we will. Why wouldn't we? We have hearts everywhere, we don't have to worry about a deal with the devil, there might be something good in here. Like two tarot cards, which are undoubtedly going to be two hero font cards. Actually, I'm gonna say one is a magician card, one is an emperor card. Oh, you guys thought your good old boys Invicta was messing with you. I almost called that. How many of you stopped and, like, had a heart-stopping moment for a second, like, oh? And then, the bad news about that is, like, if I was actually completely on target correct for that. Okay, don't ever do that again, but I will take this team sale. The reason why telepills are a little bit dangerous, because not dangerous, but they can be bad, is if they take you to the Imera room. Luckily, it did not happen. It's gonna be pin. Now you see him, now you don't. More like, now you see pin, now you don't. Curse the maze, hooray. But yeah, the telepills can take you to the Imera room, which can be bad, because it can cause you to basically miss an entire floor, and that's not quite good. Luckily now that we know what the telepills look like, we don't have to worry about that. I'm not under any sort of pretenses here with this Emperor card. Never mind. I was going to say how I wasn't going to use it, but I will use it once we get a full charge to save our deal with the devil, but apparently I just don't know how to play this game, and we just lost our deal with the devil, so... That was about one of the worst moves I have ever done. I don't know why I thought that I was going to be able to dodge out of that when I didn't have an angle to retreat from, so... There you go. And it's plays like that that make me not call myself a good player. Because that's just inexcusable right there. That's just downright bad. And I feel the need to, like, apologize for plays that are that bad. We're going to take a hit here. Oh, maybe not. I wouldn't have cared, obviously, because we don't have our deal with the devil anymore. We do have a chance of getting it. It's not the end of the deal with the devil, but I almost feel like I don't deserve it. And I have been known to just completely not take devil deals because I didn't feel like I deserved it. Which might sound like a silly notion, but... You know, it's better than sounding like Billy Ocean. Actually, no, it's not. Billy Ocean's kind of good. We have a full charge. Might as well use that. Small rock would be awesome. Even more soul hearts, the better. Still looking for our item room. Let's see if we get hooked up here. Do we have a shot at getting a deal with the devil? I mean, there's always a shot, but... I would be surprised if we got one. We have just slightly better than a 1 in 3 chance. It's gonna be Little Horn, it's gonna be Dead Horn. No deal with the devil. You know what? That's definitely 100% earned. I don't think we should have gotten a deal with the devil. To be quite honest, I was actually contemplating not taking one, even if we got one. You gotta play better. Bad play shouldn't be rewarded. Alright, inside our item room, we got the T5. Hooray. Ooh, man, just knocking... Or sorry, the D10. Just knocking this one out of the park, Isaac. Now, can we hit this with one bomb? It is possible. Got a key, alright. Don't really need to stay here for anything else. I mean, we could go into the store and get something... What are we really looking for in there? We don't need soul hearts right now. A bomb would be nice, I will admit, but I think we'll just head on down to the next floor. No deal with the devil, no surprise, and 100% warranted. But what we really need now, this is going to be a make or break floor for us. We really need damage. Damage and range. This room in particular is showing how bad our range actually is. 23, while it might seem like a lot because we're over 20, it's really not. Especially if your shot speed is only 0.81. So this is definitely a make or break. I don't know why I decided this. I didn't even have to do that. I could have just walked out of there. Those don't count as mobs. We need damage. I mean, I'll take whatever the game wants to give me. You want to give me, like, you know, Jesus Juice? Fine. You want to give me Chemical Peel? Fine. Jesus Juice would actually not be a bad item to get here. I'm going for the Concussive Poops because they actually deal a little bit of damage, as you see right there. We've already softened up some of the bomb flies. The non-champion ones are dead. There we go. Alright, I will scope out what's in the mob trap room here. It's going to be Seraphim, which I think is probably worth taking. Was that worth using Krampus's head for? Nah. But, I mean, to be quite honest, we've got Seraphim, which is going to help out our DPS quite a bit. In this early going, anyway. I mean, Seraphim's damage isn't that bad. I mean, I'm pretty sure that the base damage of Seraphim is actually better than our current damage. But don't quote me on that, because I don't have any exact numbers. The Seraphim is a familiar that you rarely see, but it will do these little Sacred Heart-esque type shots that... They do a moderate amount of damage. It's a good amount of damage for a familiar, for sure. Now, if you can get Seraphim combined with BFF, you've got yourself some pretty gnarly damage there. For follower damage, anyway. Sloth goes down. We get a Stars card. I will use now. I mean, Iron Bar gives us damage. It gives us a little bit of crowd control as well with the concussive shots, which I'm not really going to complain about. We just needed any damage, so we got exactly what I asked for. And, yeah. That's a good get. Would really love to get the Potato Peeler. The potato peel. The potato peeler would give us even more damage. And it would also give us another... It would actually probably give us Meat Boy. Before we consider taking the potato peeler, we need to find out what we're going to get out of our devil deal, if we get one. Actually, we will get one, as long as we don't take radar damage, which... At this point, it's inconceivable that we will not... get a devil deal, because we would have to lose... we'd have to get hit 7-8 times total to be inflicted with red heart damage. I've been playing too much Lobotomy Corporation. I'm like, oh, we gotta resist red damage. What do we need for that? Oh, we need that Aleph's armor. What a game, man. What a game.
We get us addicted. God, stop talking about Lobotomy Corporation.
Look, I'm gonna talk about whatever I want in these Isaac videos, alright? I've gotta talk about something to keep everyone entertained. I can't just be like, okay, well, we're done with this floor, and, okay, oh, look, we found a dead end, gee golly willikers, I guess we'll just backtrack over here, and we're gonna go down, and then we're gonna go down again, take a left, well, it's Isaac's right, and then, we're just gonna keep going straight. I gotta dodge these mushrooms, and, let's say, ooh, we can get a couple of cents here, it's good enough for the potato peeler, and, okay, let's... Looks like a little bit of a portal room, so we gotta be careful. We don't want to get hit by the bomb flies now, because that would be really bad. I think that the super secret room is right here, and I think that maybe we can possibly get something out of there. It looks like it's a bunch of runes or something. Maybe we'll take the black rune. We'll see which ones we've got here. It would be nice to get a Dagaz rune or a Yara rune, or a double Yara rune would be neat. Don't really need the Ensa's runes right now. I think I'm going to take the black rune, and we're going to go over here, and we're going to kill off these little poop things and just wait for that to get cleared. Then we'll go into the boss room. Oh, we got another bomb. Okay, well, it's going to be mega fatty, and then we're just going to use Krampus's head and try not to take in too much damage here. Just don't want to get hit by any of the barrels in case we do need to use them for its explosive properties. We get Cat of Nine Tails, and let's see, we get a Devil Deal. It's Little Brimstone. I don't really like Little Brimstone, but I guess I'll take it for the deal with the devil. See, you don't want that. Alright, you gotta let me talk about what I want. No one's gonna tune in for that. I will use the Black Rune here to get a stat up. Hopefully damage. We did. I do want to use the Yara rune inside the store. Now, why am I going to use the Yara rune inside the store? Well, it's to possibly get enough money. Well, we get to see what kind of card this is too, but more importantly, we get a soul heart out of it. Now, the question is, are we going to use... Yeah, devil card... Are we going to use the Yara rune again or the Emperor card? I mean, it makes more sense to use the Yara rune here instead of going with the Emperor card. The Emperor card we're going to keep until we either need to get rid of it or until we get to the chest, basically. So we're going to Yara rune this uno mas, and we'll grab some free money that we made appear out of thin air, which, man, how awesome would that be? We're going to buy that last soul heart. Get a full charge, and then go get our Emperor card. So a little Brimstone is not a bad pickup here. Far from it, in fact. I will say that I think that little Brimstone by itself is a little bit overrated, but that doesn't mean it's bad. But the damage that you can get with little Brimstone if you have BFF is phenomenal. I do think that little Brimstone gets confused with a hard carry item, though. I mean, like, little Brimstone, no one's going to argue with... I'm not going to argue with the fact that it can carry you through runs. It's just a very slow carry. I mean, like, a very, very real slow... very, very real slow carry. He can do it. It's just... hopefully you don't have to... It doesn't have to come to that. Alright, boss trap room we don't care about. We've been getting lucky on the no curses lately. I mean, on this run. Not lately, but on this run in particular. I kind of sounded like Rick Moranis from Ghostbusters. I'm playing that little bit in my head now. I'm like, I didn't mean to come off like Rick Moranis from the original Ghostbusters. That's the kind of life I want to have one day. I want to be famous enough to where everyone in the world knows me, and then I just completely just peace out. Like nobody, like I drop out of the spotlight. You know, I don't want to. I enjoy my private life. You know, Rick Moranis is notorious for he just fell off the face of the earth. He chooses not to act anymore. I believe some of it was due to his wife's health reasons or something like that. I'm just completely firing up the cup here. I remember reading something a long time ago about like, where is Rick Moranis? If you don't know who Rick Moranis is, then you weren't alive in the 80s. Or the early 90s. You talk about getting typecasted, man. Rick Moranis was typecasted as the nerd and as the nerd or in the, as like the meek, shy, like little anti-manly man, you know, character in any movie that he was in. Great actor though. Some of you probably know him more from Ghostbusters than you do from the Little Shop of Horrors. There's something about musicals that I don't. I'm talking about Little Shop of Horrors, but I'm also thinking about the musical and movie of the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and really just any semi musicals or musicals in general. Like even Disney films, like I never really was, oh my god, I never really was, like, okay with the idea of just busting out into a song. You know, I mean, it's hard to criticize old school Disney movies because they were actually really good. I just didn't like the singing parts. I don't know why. I don't know if there's anyone out there like that that just really does not like musicals. And it's because, like, I don't want to, I don't know, I might be being cynical a little bit, but if I want to watch a movie, or like see it like a performance, I don't want it to be sung to me. I want acting. I want like, you know, props, or you know, if we're talking about just movies in general, like I want to just sit back and watch. Like I don't want to, you know, I would never watch a Godzilla musical. That just sounds like the worst idea in the face of the planet. I mean, it just sounds terrible, you know. But some people really like. Super hardcore into musicals. One of my best friends is really into musicals. I'm like, I can't. I don't know why. I don't consider myself, you know, uncultured. You know, I may not be as cultured as most people, but you know, Oh, okay. It must be the second time that we saw Mom's Coin Purse. Thank you, game. I mean, we do have Virgo, so I guess. Verp. We don't have any trinket. And relax. No deal with the devil. I don't remember what our chance of a deal with the devil on this one. If we didn't get one last time, it should have been like 60-something here. So, no surprise there, but that's alright. I was like, man, I just can't get down with it. I saw, you know, the last musical I saw, this was a long time ago, and I mean long, long time ago. Last musical I saw was a performance starring Jerry Lewis, who is one of my favorite comedians, doing Damn Yankees. I was young when that happened. I don't even remember what happened in the movie or in the performance. I just remember like wanting to meet Jerry Lewis so bad. And I was like, man, it would have been so much better just to stay home and watch a movie. I don't think it's fair to call people like that uncultured. You know, it's just I don't like some things. There's like, I think there's a difference between being uncultured and just saying like, yeah, I don't really like to go out, or I don't like to go to museums because I think they're boring, or art exhibits, or you know, that doesn't make you uncultured. I think that's a little unfair. Okay, and yeah, just looking for the item room here, and one day we'll find the right way to go. Okay, we're still looking. It's not cool. We don't, like, every type of person, I think that's the problem with these days, is that everyone's always looking for labels to just label someone. Not every person in the world needs a type of label. I've always sort of been against that whole mentality of, like, you know, you're not gonna categorize me. You're not gonna generalize or stereotype, like, what I am in one word. You can't do that. I mean, you can, but I'm gonna think you're ignorant. You say, oh, he's a nerd. Well, I mean, I'm much more than that. I mean, I do a lot of things that most people probably won't consider nerdy. You know, I don't think that it's fair to just label anybody. That's the problem with the world these days. Everyone looking for a label. And if they can't find a label for you, they're gonna make one up. See, it's all about the system, man. It's the system. That's how they got you. They want to label us and categorize us. I don't know what voice this is. It's not really a voice at all. It's like crazy Woody Harrelson conspiracy theorist voice. All right, we got another Yararoon. Hooray, and friends till the end. Let's see what we can do with this Yararoon here. All right, well, I'm going to have to take that. I could have used the Yara for the nickel, but I think we can find something a little bit better than that. Another Yararoon. Alright, well now we're just getting silly rune bag. By the way, I haven't been talking about this run because there's really not a whole lot to talk about. We haven't gotten anything spectacular other than the Mark, the Cat of Nine Tails. Holy shot, of course. I mean, it's not a bad run. We just don't have anything worthy of note. Also known as noteworthy to speak about right now. I mean, we have damage. It's not great damage. Krampus's head's been doing a great job carrying us anyway. And Rune Bag has been paying out with some very useful runes, albeit some that we can't really use immediately, but we'll hold on to the bombs. We'll see. Maybe we can get a Red Heart upgrade somewhere. I would like a cheaper deal with the Devil since this is one of the few ones that we'll actually get a chance to get. We've only gotten two deals with the Devil in this entire run, I think, or maybe even just one. Have we only gotten one? I think we've only actually gotten one. Ooh, that was close. Alright, thank you very much, Random Bomb. Alright, gonna be another dead end here. Yep, alright. Gee, I wonder what's over here. Could it be? Maybe it's another dead end. That would be really weird if this was another dead end. But not inconceivable. I've never really fit in with the whole archetype of a particular group of people. Like back when I was a kid growing up, a couple years ago, like you only have two classifications of people in high school. You've got nerds. Did we have it? Yeah, there we go. You've got nerds and then you've got jocks. That was it. And like if you weren't a jock, then you were automatically a nerd. That's just how it was. At least playing on the football team anyway. You know, that whole stereotypical archetype of person. But like now it's like, okay, well we gotta find a label for everyone. So man, I'm not special enough to have my own label. I better just make one up. That's a problem, man. People are making up all these labels nowadays. It's like what you people are crazy. Why do we need labels for everything? Labels are for like buying stuff or warning labels. They're not for people. That's not for people consumption. What are we really looking for here? Well, first we need to go back and get our Emperor card. We've been to our item room. We've been to the store. We've already missed Boss Rush by a little bit, so I don't think it's that bad to just explore, do a little bit more perusing. Oh, Brimstone. Thank you. Oh, there's a fly there. I didn't even see that. I will take that. I don't know what we need on this run. I really don't. Flying would be nice. we need to not be in this room, I can tell you that. So done. I'm like the most done that I could ever be with those freaking ghosts. They just take too many hits. Alright. I will use a couple bombs here and to see if we can get maybe some Yara runable soul hearts. I mean, one's not really worth it, but we're not gonna take the Yara rune with us, so I guess there's no reason not to. So we'll pick up an extra 4 HP here. Because since we're not going to get an HP upgrade, we definitely need to get as many soul hearts as possible. Assuming that it's not a Krampus fight, which it probably will be, just because I know my luck. A lot of people asking me, am I going to be playing Monster Hunter World for PC? Of course I am. Some of you may not have been around for the months leading up to Monster Hunter World, but it was one of the rare times that I've been doing this. That I've been, like, aggressively pumped up, ready to go for a game. Normally, I don't get super hype, as the kids call everything, because it's just like you're playing like someone's. You're basically being someone's like pitch at that point. You know what I mean? Like you're doing someone else's job for them. They don't need to pay an advertising budget because they've got you. I'm speaking. Oh, okay. Curse the XL. Well, that's our punishment for taking Mom's knife. Mom's knife's been showing up so much lately, and I'm okay with it. 100% okay with this. That one camouflaged really well. I know, but I mean, people are gonna be rolling their eyes even after I said like I will always make the winning decision here. But I think this run was won regardless of having Mom's knife or not. I think that this is a one run. Okay, so it's gonna be a dead end in this nightmare fuel of a room. only in a Curse the XL, only Sinvicta could find the first wrong way to go on one try. Isn't that amazing? The gods would be awesome. Thank you, the gods. Awesome only in the sense that like it gives us one of our soul hearts back that we've lost. I forgot what I was saying now. Oh, Monster Hunter, yeah. I rarely ever get pumped up. Everyone's like, oh, did you see the trailer for da-da-da-da-da-da-da? And I'm like, no. Or sometimes I'll be like, yeah. Like, I saw the trailer for the new Godzilla movie for King of the Monsters. And I'm pumped about it. I'm really happy about it. But, like, you know, for the next year, I'm going to be doing, like, a Godzilla podcast or something. I'm sure that, are there Godzilla podcasts? I don't even know, man. I don't listen to podcasts. I really don't. I just don't have time to, like, just sit back and just listen to someone speak. And I know that it sounds like, okay, well, anyone can say that they're just super busy. I think I have seen a lot. There's a big trend in new media. Sometimes when you hear, not all the time, of course, but sometimes when you hear new media personalities or YouTubers or streamers in general, they're like, oh, just so busy, just so busy. Spoiler alert, they probably aren't that busy. They just don't feel like doing anything. And I can attest to that because I have felt that way before. I have felt the need to say like, oh man, I'm super, like I'm bogged down right now. I've got so much going on and everything. Another Yara rune. When in reality, I just want to have a day off. You'll hear that a lot from streamers. They'll just say that they're kind of tired or they just need to chill out or whatever. That's because they're most likely just burnt out and they just need some mental recovery time. Not every time, of course. Again, I'm not trying to generalize. Well, we actually got to deal with the devil, and we're not gonna take it. All right, not gonna fight Hush. I fought Hush. We have fought Hush many times this week without really needing to. Okay, a little brimstone fired while we were in the loading screen. That's a new one. But for the record, yes, I have seen the new Godzilla trailer. And it does look like it's going to be a real Godzilla movie. I'll tell you which Godzilla movie you all need to see right now. If you are fans, some people liked it, some people didn't like the first Godzilla anime on Netflix. I can definitely see the point of not liking the first one. Because it doesn't have, it's not a lot of Godzilla, there's a lot of exposition. I mean, a whole lot. And it falls under very familiar anime, like, archetypes and tropes. It's just, it's familiar. For those of you who've ever seen anime, like, you're gonna, some of the elements discussed and portrayed in Godzilla and the anime, the Netflix series, is very predictable. But I still enjoy it because I like anything that's entertaining, and especially if it's Godzilla related, I'll watch it. I'm a big Godzilla fan. But with that being said, for those of you who may not have felt the first one was that great, definitely watch part two. The second Godzilla movie in the anime series came out, I think, this month in July. And it is thoroughly good. I mean, it is, it's just great. Worth watching. Now, if you're not a Godzilla fan, then you're not going to like it. But the only thing that I will say that alludes to something, without being a hypocritical, you know, spoiling douchebag, is that if you're an old school, Godzilla fan, I mean old school Godzilla fan, there are some things and some characters that you that are discussed and seen in the second anime episode that will be very exciting, and that's all I'm saying. I completely called the ending, by the way. And for those of you who do end up watching it, make sure you stick around after the credits. The post-credit scene is huge. But what I'm trying to say is that for those of you who thought that the first anime was just sort of like boring, which again, I totally understand why you would think that. Don't worry, it's gonna get better. So I highly recommend watching the second one. So good. Being greedy here, but it's just because we've got Virgo and we also have Polar Invincibility. Whoop. And I do watch it. I don't watch with the English dub. And I know how some people perceive that. They're like, oh, you're like, you know, anime elitist or whatever made up word that they call that. Isaac's Heart. Libra. I don't think we take anything. I wouldn't call myself an anime elitist. I think that the Japanese voice actors just do a better job. It just sounds more, natural. You know? Oh no, definitely check it out. Thank you for watching. Great run. Thank you, Mom's Knife. Thank you, Krampus's Head. MVP definitely goes to Krampus's Head for making that run easy. Subscribe here. Make sure you leave a like or dislike. Either way, it helps out support the channel. Make sure you ring the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos do go live here on YouTube. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.